Welcome back, my YouTube friends. It's time to check out some customs. So check it out. What if? Think about this as a question to all my customizing friends out there. Because, hey, you might want to take a shot and try this out. Like me, Jake at Strictly Diecast, and Jeremy over at Ready2Diecast challenge we decided to take on. So I've always had this idea and I decided to share it with them. And we've had this fun challenge. Is what if those famous movie cars, those iconic cars, you know, for example, Knight Rider, Ghostbusters, Back to the Future, what if the cars that were used in those shows or movies were not that model car, but something from that era instead? What could they look like? What could you come up with? I'll show you guys an example. Long time ago when I was just starting customs a couple years, well, I say a long time ago, a couple years ago now, I made this. This is one of my very first customs, and this is not my typical to do something like this, but it's a perfect example of what I'm talking about. And I know I'm not the only one that's done this. I'm sure somebody else has done this first. I saw the idea and thought it was fun to make a cool combi out of an Ecto-1. See, we got the Ecto packs in the back there. Got all the got the right wheels. Got all the equipment on the roof. So this is just an example of what I'm talking about. Like, what if they didn't have the Ecto-1, but instead they had a cool combi? So we're going to check that out, and I'm going to show you guys what show I chose a show to come up with for an alternative car for that particular show. So to be honest with you guys, I've had some customs laying around that I haven't showed you guys, or at least I don't think I have. We're going to go over some of those, and then we're going to show you guys the particular show slash movie car that I came up with for our challenge. If you guys haven't seen it yet, go check out Jake's. He just showed his over at Strictly Diecast. And Jeremy, I'm not sure if he showed his yet, but you guys are definitely going to want to see his over at Ready2Diecast. He did an incredible job. We had a lot of fun with this. It's fun to inspire each other and have some fun with this challenge. So real quick, I'm just going to go over the S15. I know you guys already saw this probably in the short that I did, but it's just kind of fun to take a second look at it here. And by the way, this is the fully custom Target Red Edition that I made here. And I got the decals from Hayden over there at HHWC, which is right there. Shout out to him for his excellent quality decal kit. Really good 3D parts too. You guys are going to see some fun stuff coming soon that I picked up from them. But yeah, I just made my own custom Red Edition with those decals there, which you guys have already seen this one. So it's fun to make these cool little display cases for this stuff. It really kicks them up a notch a little bit there. And then, of course, you guys saw this Silverado already. But we'll go over it here a little close up. Unfortunately, getting these cars to roll really good can sometimes bite you in the butt. And they get smacked around in these cases and can get away from you sometimes. And unfortunately, this one did, and I'm really not happy about that. But it was very small, as you can see right there on the bed. Can't fix it now. It's too late. It's in a bad spot. But it is what it is. So, as you guys can see, I made my own little custom bed here out of real wood. Sort of like a work truck bed, you know? Like this man works on this truck. So, sort of went for that sort of pro touring look. I came up with, these are LODC wheels, but those aren't LODC tires. I tell you guys, I wish LODC would make different style tires because I love their wheels. So, I believe these are Real Rider tires that I popped on there. I'm not really sure. I can't remember, but I just had to put my own kind of tires on there to get that own, that stance and that look. See how it just looks nice and fat and tucked and nice and clean. So the LODC tires just would not accomplish that. So I had to use these instead. So sometimes you got to mix stuff up to get that look you want. So, and that's what I did for this piece. So this next piece is a piece that I love so much that I just couldn't completely alter it. Meaning I couldn't strip it and repaint it, because when it comes to an R33, that's my favorite GTR, I love the HKS livery, and if you guys know that, there was that recent 2-pack that came out with the van and the R33. I love that car. But how could I improve on it, maybe make it, put my own spin on it? That's what I wanted to do, but I didn't want to change it up. I didn't want to strip it. I just wanted to make it my own, and I came up with this. So it's a crazy chameleon paint job on here that's real reflective. I mixed up a pretty crazy mix for this and just threw it right over the top of the HKS livery. Got it stanced out, put my own custom exhaust on there, 3D printed muffler, and this is what I came up with. So still that cool HKS. I did add a few decals on there, like the chrome Advan and a few on the sides, but I love this car so much and I love this model. So I just wanted to have a little fun with it and experiment and try something out. So came up with this crazy chameleon. It's purple, blue, all kinds of fun in there. But love that car, love that livery. Another fun challenge I wanted to give myself is I thought, what if I took a car that nobody really likes and all of us see on the pegs? Right there. The little Alfa Romeo. What was this model car again? The Giulia, yeah. That whole orange Fast and Furious. It seems like no matter what store you go to, those things are peg warm in there. And I thought, hey, what if I took a car that was a peg warmer that not many people like, which it is a pretty cool little car in real life, and try to make my own unique custom out of it. So I came up with this, and it's a little different. And I had to mix up different decals from different sets, chop them up, and come up with my own unique idea here to sort of try to keep with the era, because I didn't have a lot of decals from like this era, and I tried to make my own little road race car out of it using some Lucky Strike, some Michelin, Ray-Ban, just a whole mix of different decals to come up with this little guy. Again, another one of those good rollers got away from me here. But yeah, I was just really struggling to try to find a wheel that I thought could look cool on this little guy here. So I came up with these torque thrust for it. Painted all the trim. Like I said, I mixed up a bunch of different decals kits and sort of just blended them together to sort of try to keep it the right era there. Had to hand paint my own taillights because obviously I'm not going to have headlight and taillight tampos for this. Metal base, this was the premium. But yeah, I just thought, eh, let's have some fun with a peg warmer, see if we can make it look good there. So, came up with this Lucky Strike livery. Fun custom mix color. Again, I like doing that and creating custom colors. Moving on. So now we're up to the show movie car challenge that we did to see what we all could come up with. And the particular show that I used was the General Lee from Dukes of Hazzard, which I believe was a 68 Charger, 67, 68 Charger. God knows how many of them they smashed up for that show. But watching that car do all those crazy jumps and stuff, that's what was entertaining as a kid. And I thought I could get those decals, because that's the other thing I had to think of. And that was part of the rules that we had to sort of fit in there, was we had to use something from that era. So I found the particular casting and decals to be able to come up with this. And I came up with my own custom 67 Firebird General Lee. So keeping up with that era, I found a 67. I can't remember where I had that motor. I think I got it out of a monster truck. I've since gotten some 3D motors, which I'd rather have used, but I went ahead and just stuck with this one. Got the push bar on there. Let's get it out of the case. Yeah, I did find a 3D printed push bar. Got that attached. Meticulously painted all the trim around the front bumper. Like I said, I believe I originally got that motor out of like a monster truck. And I glued that blower on there. Can't remember where I got that. Tried to make my own custom sort of spark plug wires on there. Just kept it looking fun. Like, you know those boys would be getting some crazy jumps with that kind of power. Boss Hog ain't going to catch this. Painted the interior sort of like a beige tan color. polished the whole casting. This was the metal base. Painted the bumper in chrome. Got that nice fat stance. Got the tires tucked. The torque thrust. Goodyear raised white letter tires. Roll cages painted orange to match. Steering wheel shifter. Few details in there. I don't think I can get you guys in there on any of this stuff, but yeah, it's got its own custom steering wheel shifter in there. Like I said, roll cage painted to match. Yep, just a fun, different, what if it was a 67 Firebird instead of the Charger. So yep, that was my entry for the movie/show car challenge. Keeping it up with the General Lee, something you guys, I don't think you saw, and I'm going to end up redoing it, but I'll show you guys anyway, is I came up with sort of a modern version of one that I thought could be kind of fun. However, I had some issues with the clear and the paint on this, but you guys can see overall what I was shooting for here. Yeah, so basically I had some issues with the clear and ended up having to put a little too much clear on it, and but this casting was so nice that I got to give it another shot, because I'm going to try to get that Spectre Flame a little bit better, or the candy, I should say, look a little bit better. As you guys can see on the roof, how it kind of turned yellow. I had a bug fly into the clear, and it messed up the that nice sheen and orange that I had on this one. Did a really nice job on that carbon fiber hood. It's a shame, but like I said, I know I can get this a little bit better. So, but I wanted to show you guys, being it was General Lee, and I thought it was kind of cool to do like a modern version of a Charger with the livery. So, all right, guys, that's it for this one. Just wanted to show you guys this, my rendition of the 67 Firebird General Lee, as far as the challenge goes. Definitely go check out Jake's over at Strictly Diecast and Jeremy's over at Ready2Diecast. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Take it easy.